All right, Coach, how you doing? This is Washington, over east, Washington High School. And folks, here we are at the at Morgan Park High School. There's a game between Washington High, Patriots, at Morgan Park. Conference game. The Patriots just joined the Jackie Robinson South Conference. And we sent Brooks packing to another conference. So here we go, varsity baseball here at Morgan Park High School, IHSA baseball. Woo, pull the string, strike. And on the bump for the Mustang is Chakel Eggleston, number 19, a senior at Morgan Park. Threw in that big sweeping curve to get the batter out. Up high. Strike. On the swing. We've got a 1-2 count. Here's a 1-2. Off the plate, 2-2. Oh, there's a knock. Scooped up by the shortstop, LeVar. They throw first. In time. They get the out. Blue is right on top of the play. Two away. Right on number 12, you got to put a glove on those balls. Second drop today. Up in the zone. Strike is called. Two on the swing. And the payoff fouls him back. Up high. Swings through, struck him out, and that will retire the sides. Midway through the first, no score. Morgan Park coming to bat. Back of the cameraman I just met. He has my cell number. On the bump, number 19, I believe that's Lopez for the Patriots. He has a brother, number 23, also on the team. I think he plays short. bottom of the first inning, Morgan Park at bat. Leading off for the Mustangs is James Davidson, center fielder, a junior at Morgan Park. Throws bunt, takes the ball. Oh, there's a drive. Left field. Foul ball. Oh, yeah. Yeah, he was already at second. Time is called. That drive was foul, so James will get another crack at it. Steps in the batter's box. Up in the zone. Foul them all. Three balls, two strikes. The pitch. Walked them. Mustangs have a runner on. That brings Reggie Rogers to, that's number seven. LeVar Reed to home plate for the Mustangs. Short lead at first. Checks the runner. Good pickoff move by number 19. Short lead. Here's a pitch. And there goes the runner. The ball gets away. Head first slide for James. Perhaps could have turned the corner on that one. There's the bunt. Back to the mound to throw the first. In time. They get the runner at first. The sacrifice bunt to move James over to third base. Runner in scoring position for the Mustangs. One away. In the three spot, Reggie Rogers, a senior at Morgan Park. First pitch strike. Off the plate. In the dirt. Ball two. Ball gets away, and here comes the base runner. He will cruise in for the score. Mustangs by one. Here's the 3-2. Walked him. Mustangs have their second runner on base. And that brings up Johnny in the five spot. And a chant of Johnny. fouls him back, first pitch. Woo! Checks the runner at first, gets back. Again. Off the plate. One ball, one strike. Shot went right at us. Giant digs in for the 1-2 pitch, a short lead at first. Once again, we're in the bottom of the first. Oh, there's a shot. It's cool and everything. Almost got coach on that one. Staying on top. Ready to watch out over here in camera's row. Once again. Short lead at first, four digs in. Here's a pitch. Oh, and there's a drive. Way back left field, over the left fielder's head. And out of here, he finally hit one over the softball fence for a home run. That's number four, Johnny Stevenson. Lights one up for a two-run shot over the 400-foot fence by the girls softball diamond.
That's the first time he's done that.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was the last team that went to the quarterfinals.
Okay, okay.
He played in that with that bunch.
Morgan Park's doing it, man. Football. Oh, that was with gold. Last year?
No.
That was in Spurlock?
Spurlock.
Okay. Okay, last year was Spurlock, okay.
He had the last 4 years of Spurlock.
Right.
They were pretty good.
Just girl softball.
My cousin used to play over there, Jackie Robinson.
That's possible.
You know, Michael Wilson?
The name doesn't jump right out, but that don't matter.
It got on the basketball team. About this tall.
You're going to be Spud? What's that, the guy Spud?
Oh, man. I said, man, baseball is your shot.
The size don't matter.
Don't matter.
Mm-hmm. It don't matter. And so
fast, very fast.
Yes, like number one, the leadoff guy for this team.
Real fast.
Speedy. You saw him, probably saw him run all the way around the base of that foul ball.
Yeah.
That was James Davidson. Okay. That boy got wheels.
Who they playing? Who is
it? Washington. Washington just joined the Jackie Robinson League. Brooks was in there, so Brooks is out now. Washington is in. So we've actually, we may have played them before. I don't think so, though.
Did it?
Who's it?
You didn't see it? Look at the back of that little house. Back of that little house.
This field fence is a football fence. Unless it bounced over. Unless it bounced over here. Is he playing sports?
Oh, he played football. Go for the sports that.
I'm gonna ask you to.
They have a lot of scholarships.
Head first slide. Did he get in there? He did. Head first slide helped him. It's not gonna be that loud. On the swing. Short lead at second base. Oh. Checks the runner. Runner gets back. Just barely. Still in the first inning. Folks, we're in the bottom of an extended first inning. Morgan Park has picked up three runs. Two came off of the bat of number four, Johnny Stevenson, the catcher, who sent that ball 400 feet over the softball fence. Oh, fouls that one off.
he'll be back.
Okay. Yates. That's Yates, Coach Yates.
Usually it takes 4 years to get, you know, stupid stuff.
On the swing, it throws third. Oh, up high, and the runner is safe. But that's a strike him out, throw him out, which the strikeout came out first. That's strike three and the third out. So at the end of one, Mustangs by three.
You don't mind running it.
No.
Mm-hmm. It's important, man.
Yeah.
Conditioning is important.
He's an asthmatic, you know. He's only doing too much. That's more the reason he should be running. To expand his lungs, to keep the fluid out of him.
There you go.
Strong.
I've had older people come to me for saxophones. I teach band and finger. And that would help their lungs.
You get a private saxophone?
I don't now. I'm following my kids and never seen your phone. That just goes to show you how much, how many people I come in contact with. And they're repeat customers. Folks, we're at the top of the second inning. The Mustangs have put a three spot on the board. Washington, the visiting team, is up to bat. Shaquille's on the bump, Giants behind the plate. I'll call it. Here's the pitch, low and away.
Last time he had the back, hold the back. Too long to put the back.
Oh, strike two. Two balls, two strike.
Plus, he's a little guy, so I know he's not going to power the back.
Walk him.
He's not going to swing the back, power the back. He's not big enough.
2-8-2. First pitch off the plate. Go ahead, man. Runner thinks about it, thinks better of it. Okay. I'm gonna punch you in there. Oh, good. Yeah, eating healthy too. There you go. Foul them back. Tua, she's a big meat eater. So we're working on that.
But how old is she?
She's 46.
She'll learn.
Yeah.
Trust me. In a few more years, she'll be there.
We're baking and broiling and there's a fly ball. Short center.
Got it.
Catch is made. And then they chase the base runner back, overthrow him by a bit, but he gets back. They don't exist.
Man, they used to play some baseball.
I'm a graduate finger.
Oh, yeah?
So 75.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You only got me by a minute. And so it's...
Mm-hmm. Young, mm-hmm. He hasn't hit her yet, but she's at the end of young.
Yeah.
So she's at the end of. You ain't got people about that meat. You don't have to tell.
How healthy you are? And she's a nurse.
Oh, she know better.
Yeah.
You don't clog up your arteries.
There's a fly ball. Shortstop is under it. Makes the catch. To throw the first. Runner gets back once again. Two away. VAR. How many outs, VAR? You don't hear me.
Your name again. Maybe you can do something. It's my next stop.
That's what I was saying. That's what I was asking if you play sports.
Yeah,
he looked like a bruiser, boy. Really?
See? It's my next All-State.
Look out, man.
He's going to be a lineman, though.
Yeah, he looked like a bruiser. And there goes the runner. We're going to have plenty of time. I'm going to send you some stuff. I'm going to send you some stuff by text. Okay. How many outs, VAR? little conversation with a old school Morgan Park graduate. Chases that one down. Woo! For the third out. We're midway through the second inning. Morgan Park has held Washington at bay. Morgan Park leads by 3 runs, and Morgan Park coming to bat. Bottom of the second inning, 17 at bat. Pitch low and away. Oh, there's a drive back to the mound. Throw the first in time. Next to bat for the Mustangs. Shows bunt, takes the strike. The chant of Devo. Low and in. Two balls, one strike. Strike two. Here's a 2-2. Oh, there's a rip up the middle. Base hit. And that brings up the top of the lineup for the Mustangs. Devo is sporting number 17. I have to remember that. A short lead at first. And there goes the runner. Safe at second. Stolen base for second stolen base of the day for Mustang base runners. James got the first and James at bat. Fouls them off. And now we play. Shortly the second, the pitch. Oh, there's the bunt. Down the third baseline. Oh, unable to find the ears on that one. They throw the second. They get the runner at second. They catch James being a little bit greedy. Well, I think he was trying to send number 24 and divert attention from himself. Runner on third, LeVar Reed at the plate. The pitch. Goes the base runner, and Devo slides in safely for the fourth run of the day for the Mustangs. Actually stole home. And Morgan Park is getting it done by whatever means necessary. Swings through. Strike two. Oh, got a piece of that one, fouled it off. Look at this member of the football team hanging out watching the game with us. In the dirt for ball three. Come on. ball three there. Stand corrected. His 3-2 count. Oh, there you go. It lifts one straightaway center and caught for out number three, and that will end the inning. At the end of one, at the end of two, Morgan Park by four. First pitch, strike. Folks, we're at the top of the third inning. Chakel on the bump, finding his spots now. I think this is his third start on the season. Still looking for his first win. Today could be the day. Here's 2-2. Low and in, ball three. Get him with the curve, Kales. On the swing, struck him out. One away. Top of the third, and Shaquille is putting on the show. That brings up a southpaw for the Patriots. The pitch, strike. Oh, there's a drive. Left field and foul. Yeah, they got dry out sometime. Swings through. Two away. Y'all don't retrieve wet balls? I think. Two away, top of the third for the Patriots. First pitch low in. Here comes the bullpen for the Patriots. Strike is called. You okay, coach? On the swing, shack-a-lack.
What you got? Top three? About 4-0.
Okay. It's a payoff. In there for strike three. Struck him out. And the Patriots go down in order. We're midway through the third. Mustangs in control of the game, up by four runs, and coming to bat. The highlight of the game thus far, a two-run shot over the left field fence by Johnny Stevenson, the catcher for the Mustangs. And I want to show you a picture of where the ball went. First time he's literally gone yard over that softball fence. That's got to be a good 400 feet, maybe more. Right over there. Bottom of the fourth. First pitch gets by.
What's up, big guy? What's going on? I'm just taking pictures.
Who was?
My dad
checks his swing, takes a strike. One away. In the five spot for the Mustangs, number four, Johnny Stevenson, taking all the way. There's a rip. Gets through. Johnny is 2 for 2 in this game. Was thinking about more. We'll get back. A home run and a single. A couple more at bats. We might be looking at the cycle. Short lead at first. Thinks about going. Thinks better of it. Swing through. Short lead at first base. Oh, ball gets away. And Johnny will advance to second base easily. On the pass ball. Batter digs in. There's the bunt. Down the third baseline. Nobody's gonna get that. And that puts runners at the corners for the Mustangs. All right, trying to get it done. Try and get it done. We want our picture on the attendance office wall. Yeah, I was in there the other day and I saw all the state championship basketball team up there. Yeah. We'll give them a few more weeks and then we'll go ahead and put it up there. Short lead at both bases, first and third. Straight down Broadway, stride. Oh, down the third baseline. The scoop. Oh, throws it away. Run number 5 will score for the Mustangs. And the two trailers will hold up at second and third base respectively. Mustangs by 5. That brings number 24 to home plate. That's number 20, I'm sorry. Swings through, stride. That's Jamil Brown. The third baseman for the Mustangs, at bat number 20, a freshman at Morgan Park. Runners on second and third, a good lead at second. Low. Charles is on second base. Two on the swing. Oh, fouls it off. 20 digs in. Again. Up and in. Two balls, two strikes. Runners on second and third base for the Mustangs with a 5-run lead. Oh, swings through, struck him out. Second out of the inning for the Mustangs here in the bottom of the third. With two out, 17 steps to home plate. First pitch strike. Swings through. Quickly 0-2 on the batter. Low. Here's a 2-2. Low. Ball three. Three balls, two strikes, two away. Runners on second and third. The 3-2 pitch. Up in the zone. Oh, they're calling that ball three. Here's a 3-2. Swings through, struck him out, and that will end the inning. At the end of three, Mustangs by five. Top of the fourth inning, we're just about set. 5-0 game, Mustangs on top. Chakel Eggleston on the bump. First pitch, strike. Skips one. Here's the 3-1. Walked him. Strike is called. One ball, one strike. Checks the runner at first. up in the zone. Here's a 2-1. Make that 3-1. That's two walks in a row, and here comes Coach. Trying to protect a 5-run lead. Morgan Park pitching is just giving out 3 free passes. And here comes Coach. That might be the end of Shaquille's stint. And indeed it is. And a half strong innings by number 19, and they're bringing in a reliever, and that person is Barry. The VAR has inherited a bases loaded. Bases loaded situation and just sent the run home. By beaming one of the Patriots batters, we've got a 5-1 game. Number 7 has just beamed one of the Patriots players, and we've got a 5-1 game. Hello? Strike. Oh, checks his swing, takes a strike. On the swing, struck him out. Thank you. First pitch strike. Quickly on two on the batter. Reggie in the shortstop position, which puts there's the drive. Scooped up by Reggie to throw second, throw first. Oh, gets away, and another run will score. Base runner is safe at first. Score the run. We've got a 5-2 ball game. Good play by number two. The second baseman couldn't get the get off a good throw. And a run scored as a result. The thing about holding the runner on. There's a drive, but foul. Oh, checks his swing, takes a ball.
The gentleman over there, sir.
Huh?
The last person you saw hit the ball that way was Wes Chambers. And he paid for 2 minutes.
Wow, we're gonna measure that. We're gonna measure that and find out how far it is. Oh, there's a drive. Oh, knocked down by the third baseman. Throw the first. Not in time. To throw the third. Oh, no throw the third. Heads up by the base runner, number 23. I think that's Luna. Heads up play by 23. Luna. That was heads up by your boy.
That was good stuff.
That was heads up by your boy.
I missed the slide. Did you get a slide?
Oh, I got it. And here comes the rally call. I like good games.
Oh, yeah.
First pitch off the plate. Who's at bat?
Ruben Sierra.
Okay. Ruben Sierra at the plate for the Patriots. Inspired the motorcycles. Pitch. And while all the confusion was over there, he's on the move. Up in the zone. Patriots down 5 runs early in the last inning, have picked up a couple of runs and got runners at the corners and threatening to score once again. And again, the bases are loaded for the Patriots. The tying run at first and the go-ahead run coming to bat. Hey, coach, pull your hood up for a second. I want to get the back of your shirt. Oh, there's a drive. Third baseline to throw the first. In the dirt, gets away. 2 runs will score. And we've got a 5-4 game.
The Wills. Tied up, actually.
Is it? How many scored?
Well, 2 scored. We had 3 last.
I had 3, okay. Folks, we've got a tie ball game. 5-all tie here in the fourth inning. What appeared to be a runaway game has turned into a battle. Again, runners at the corners for the Patriots. Up high. Skips one. Short lead at first and third. Oh, on the swing. Count. Here's a 3-2. Oh, fouls him off. Three balls, two strikes, runners at the corners for the Patriots in a five ball tie. Here's the payoff. No pitch is called. Blue steps away. Here's a 3-2 pitch. Oh, pops him up. In the dirt, gets away, ball four, and that loads up the bases. I'm anticipating a pitching change after this inning for the Mustangs. Safe at third, nearly into the inning with that play. Number two cruising around, but did get back. Strike. Swings through. Fouls it off. With bases loaded, LeVar on the bump. Johnny behind the plate, the 1-2. Oh, fights it off to stay alive. Oh, struck him out. Three men stranded, but not before the Patriots pick up two more runs and have tied this ball game at five. First pitch strike, five all tie. Mustangs and Patriots are tied up in this game. All five runs for the Patriots come here in the top of the fourth inning. We're now in the bottom of the fourth. Mustangs need to make a move. Try. Oh, punched him out looking. Devo will grab some bench, and up comes the leadoff man, James Davison. spark plug for the team. First pitch blows by for strike one. Two. A little inside. Here's the 1-2. 2-2. Oh, there's a rip. Gets past the center fielder, and that'll be good for at least three bases, maybe more. James going for it all. Couldn't hang on, safe at home, and in the park home run for number one to break the tie, 6-5 ball game. Woo, James got wheels. With one out, that brings number seven, the pitcher, to home plate. First pitch in the dirt. Strike is called. Strike two is called. Here's a 1-2. Oh, pops him up. And out of play. Woo, still bouncing around there. Walked him. They just want to talk about it.
AmeriCorps is a training with us going to be in that, or?
No, that'll be separate, yeah.
But separate. He comes up 2 years from now and says, hey, I got sick doing such and such today.
You never trained me.
And you never trained me.
Yeah.
And I say, well, the hell I didn't.
Yeah, that's something you might want to keep. Like I said, how long do you keep their regular employee records?
They probably got everybody's employee.
Yeah, so yeah. I know a lot of companies keep those files somewhere. They store them. I would keep them, but again, as far as OSHA giving you a citation, you'd only need to keep them for a year. But that's a good point, because you might get guys that come, like I said, 3 years, no, you never trained me, you never.
Right.
They do that normally, right? Mm-hmm. No, you never. Yes, you did. You were in that class. You slept through it and what? So medical surveillance, special exams are required, of course, when people are working. We talked about the different types of tests you can do on this. Blood level test, what is it, chloroformin test.
Medical surveillance program.
For more than 30 days, right? Of course, we talked about the different tests. You have the right to ask for an exam if you feel sick or if you feel there's symptoms of overexposure. So you also have a right to, if an employee feels that he might be exposed, he has a right to leave this hospital. Because you must be medically removed from lead exposure, of course, if your blood level reaches that 50 micrograms per deciliter. Your doctor gives you a written medical opinion that says you should be removed from the area. So again, so that's another one. This talks about lead in construction. Of course, the 30 is what? The action level, right? So if it's at 30, under 30, you don't have any precaution. You don't have to worry about giving any protection. 30 or 50 is where you want to go ahead and requires that monitoring, right? and that the employees be properly trained on how to use their personal protective equipment, their respirators, Tyvek, and that kind of stuff. We talk about the sanitation, that's also true. So at that 30 to 50, you want to make sure that they're trained how to use the respirator, to use their Tyvek properly, sanitation, how to wash their hands, wash their face, that kind of stuff. That's part of the training they should get at that point. Of course, over 50, you want to make sure a person gets out of that environment. And of course, one of the things you have to look at too, and again, you guys don't have to worry about this much, but with other companies I work with, if they have guys that are going over that 50 micrograms per deciliter, and they're giving them protection, that tells me that this person's probably not using their protection or not using it correctly. So when you have some exposures, a lot of times you got to go back and say, well, no, we had the equipment there.
Nobody else has a problem.
Yeah, nobody else has a problem. Why is this guy having a problem? And normally it leads back to they weren't using it or not properly.
Did that still go back on, fall back on the employee?
Employer, absolutely. And that's the issue. Anytime something happens to an employee, it falls back on the employer. So again, that's why you have to do the auditing. Well, if he wasn't, what was your supervisor there for? Shouldn't he have told me he needed to do it right? I think I told you guys, or I don't know if you were in the class when I talked about one of my customers that got hit for that confined space fine, like under 10 grand. Future Environmental, they're out of Mokina. First thing around, they collect oils and stuff. But they were working at ExxonMobil, and OSHA was there doing some stuff.